Today I'm at the East Tennessee Asylum for the Insane, about 180-acre facility of mentally ill patients that was started. The original administration building is the only building left. It was started in 1884. The hospital facility opened in 1886. It was closed down by the state in 2012. So we're going to go check it out and see what it is. This used to be quite a big complex. There's very little of it left. They've tore most of it down, so I thought I'd videotape it and explore it a little bit. So let's go. Ready? So here's the original stairs that used to lead down. They used to do a bunch of farming and stuff to help keep the cost down for the state, which is where the area I just left. So, as you can see, it's changed into a park now. But this section that I'm showing you right here would have been their farmland. It's all terraced off. So, pretty interesting place. Like I said, it was originally purchased from the Indians back in the 1850s. And they had about 500 acres or so. Okay. Let's go take a look at this. The building you see in the background, we'll get to it. That's the administration building, the oldest building on site. Again, built in 1884. This place has got a wild past if you do some research on it. So here's some of the plaques of the places that the buildings that were here. There was a Keller building that's been torn down. So, here's the men's dormitory. It was erected in 1952. And they added on to this place quite a bit, pretty regular. So, it's pretty interesting. Here's their treatment building. Again, it's tore down. I know where most of this stuff is, so I'll explain it as I get closer to that area. Another woman's, I think they had two women's dormitories and one women's treatment hospital. So, and then they, you know, they made a nurse's dormitory. They had a hospital. They had a tuberculosis wing. They had quite a bit of stuff. Like I said, this is the only building left standing, which I'm not real happy about, but at least they left one of them, as opposed to you know, like Morristown College, where they dozed it all to the ground. You pretty much wiped off everything that was there. You wouldn't even know the place existed unless you did some research. So this has just been restored. I think it was 2016, so it's in pretty good shape. One of the pictures I saw, this whole awning up here in front fascia was tore off and replaced. So they've done a pretty good job of keeping it true to what it should look like. And again, so going to the right here, back over here would have been the women's wing on this side of it. Let's see where all the pretty much flat grass is and no trees. So back in the, 1960s, they had 2,600 patients here. So that gives you an idea of how big this facility was at one point. So, you know, I mean, obviously that's a pretty big building just for administration purposes. Right now, the city of Knoxville has it, and the Parks and Recreation Department uses it. And they've restored the inside and stuff. It's pretty nice. We've been in it. But like I said, it pretty much the outside, other than putting new windows in it and stuff, pretty much looks authentic to what it was. They did a few small modifications, because on this side here where we're going to, on the left side of it, would have been the men's wing. And it was actually connected to this building at one point. The women's was not. It was a completely separate, where you actually had to walk a little breezeway kind of a thing. So the reason I tell you that is, like right there, you can see where they had a hallway. I've been in the building. That's where the hallway would go into the other wing. And so they've bricked over it with pretty close to bricks that have been torn down from another facility. And so all over here, where the cars are and stuff, would have been the men's dormitory. Behind it, you would find the laundry facility, the cafeteria, and an on-site steam power plant, complete with a coal bunker, which I'll show you in just a minute. And again, you had 2,600 people, so run by the state, they did what they could to keep the price down, which makes sense to me. So, then off in the distance over here would have been the nurses' wing and housing, the tuberculosis, and the women's hospital. So that, I'm gonna zoom in. That's gonna be where all those cars are parked right there. Again, they've tore all that down. This building and the coal bunker is the only thing left standing. And the coal bunker is just the cement foundation. So it's not really much to see. I have a video of it. So, I can get this to zoom back out. There we go. So it's a pretty good place, pretty good size. So I'm kind of interested to see why this one looks like a castle and the rest of it looked kind of like Queen Anne and Victorian style. Don't quite understand that, because they were all built pretty close to the same time as far as the original part of it. So we'll see what else I can find while we roam around the place. Okay, we're back. So now, like I said, here's the coal bunker foundation. As you can see, nothing left but the coal bunker. So, and just to prove it, there's still some coal there. So again, the steam plant would have been right here where the gravel parking lot is now, along with the laundry facilities and the cafeteria and that kind of stuff. So there's still some more stairs over to the left here that you can see still existing. That at one point they built a bunch of little cottages for the less troublesome patients, that you know, to make them feel a little better at home, because once again, you know, I mean, there was a mental facility. They did some pretty awful things, you know, shock treatment, lobotomies, stuff that we kind of frown upon nowadays. So let's see if we can find, yeah, here they are. That's what I thought they were. So here's some of the old stairs that went somewhere else, obviously, which I'm guessing would be the cottages down the bottom down there that have been tore down also. But pretty neat. You can tell by it, it's the way everything's nice and shallow and built, these are pretty old. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. I wish there was more to show you, but unfortunately there's not. Like I said, check out my other videos. I'm gonna go check out the mid state and western part of the state, their asylums here shortly. So I'll add those videos up too. Again, if you like it, subscribe, click on the links if there's any links in there, and hope you enjoyed it, and see you again soon.